What's up, guys? This is my camera comparison test of the GoPro 12 versus the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra. Now, this is ultra-wide, 4K 30 on each. I know for me, when I go out and film any sort of content, whether it's just for fun, let's say family adventures, or I'm filming for my YouTube videos or TikToks or Instagram, I'm always trying to figure out, is it actually worth bringing a GoPro or an action camera along for the journey, or is the phone in my pocket gonna be good enough? By the end of this video, you guys will see all the different pros and cons of each camera system. I'm Ben Schmanke, and this is my Authentek comparison.
I'm also gonna be running a battery comparison test. GoPro notoriously has terrible battery life. I made sure both of them are fully charged 100%, and we'll do a little battery check-in later, see how they compare.
Now this is 4K 30 on each. HDR is turned on the GoPro, and the Samsung, well, it sort of automatically does all that processing. So right off the bat, which one do you guys think looks a bit better?
I'd vote the GoPro footage looks much sharper. Samsung's ultra-wide is a bit soft. The dynamic range is really nice on both, although my skin tones and some other colors kind of look off at times with each.
Quick stabilization test. This is Hyperview and extra super steady stabilization on the GoPro. I always forget what they call it. And then this is super steady on the Samsung. So it cropped in that field of view, so we're not gonna keep that ultra wide angle, which is pretty important when you're running around looking like a fool trying to test out stabilization. But hey, this is for you guys. Which one do you think looks more stable? Honestly, without even looking at the shots, I can tell you that GoPro is gonna look so much wider, so much smoother.
Okay, that is hilarious. I was 100% wrong, and the Samsung was smoother than the GoPro. Now, the GoPro's wider field of view, and we can tweak those settings, more on that in a second, but still, kudos to the Samsung.
Now, of course, I could crank up that GoPro stabilization, attach that $99 Max Lens Mod 2.0, turn on horizon leveling, or use their new paid Real Steady option.
GoPro Super View Hyper Boost, and then we got action mode on the Samsung ultrawide. All right. Here we go. Little action scene with Daniel on the e-bike.
But huge kudos to the Samsung action mode for actually keeping a smooth shot as I chase my buddy Daniel on the e-bike. Now GoPro wins with that much wider field of view, and that Samsung footage in action mode doesn't look as sharp or crispy as the normal 4K video. Here's a comparison of that, and honestly, it looks almost as smooth here in normal video mode. I'd probably leave it here for most action shots.
Now, yes, you're not gonna be jumping out of an airplane or doing motocross with your Samsung phone strapped to your chest or helmet, but for a lot of people, family vlogging, vacations, stuff like that, the smartphone in your pocket might be good enough.
This is a quick audio test. We've got some loud water fountains going on behind me. This is audio on the GoPro 12, and this is audio on the Galaxy S24 Ultra. Which one do you guys think sounds better?
Now I'll state the obvious for photo zoom. On the GoPro, since it's fixed lens, we've only got wide or a crop of linear, and that's it. So let's say I wanna zoom in all the way over there. On a smartphone like the Samsung, it's got quad camera system. So we've got the ultra wide, we've got 1X, 3X, 5, 10, and then you can even go 30 or 100 if you really wanted to. I might not recommend it, but like those 10X images, we snap that, let it process for a second, and then boom, insane clarity. You'll never get that on a GoPro.
This is just another benefit of capturing content on a smartphone. It's that diversity of optical lenses, and it makes a massive difference for creativity and better clarity at various focal lengths. We also get a macro lens on the Galaxy, and I get a lot of messages from people who don't realize that a GoPro has fixed focus. That means when the subject gets too close, it'll just be blurry. And this is the same for video. I always sort of chuckle when I see YouTube videos pointing their action cameras too close to the objects, and it's just a blurry mess.
There's no autofocus.
HDR photos on the GoPro have gotten way better over the recent years, and funny enough, I think it's colors, accuracy, and contrast. They all look even better here over the Samsung, which is very surprising to me. For max resolution, even though life is a lot more than just pixels, this is a pretty massive difference, which is pretty fascinating to compare. When we zoom in and pixel peep, you realize that all those extra pixels, they allow for more freedom for reframing and editing. And of course, for portrait or those fake shallow depth of field,
field shots, the phone will win, even though I don't think I ever want this on a GoPro. Let's talk about screen brightness. On the Samsung, it gets crazy bright, 2600 peak nits. On the GoPro, check it out, this is set to 100%. That is the difference. It is massive, especially when you're outside in the sun trying to get your action shots. It's pretty bad that this rear display is so dim on the GoPro. I definitely wish it was much brighter like we see on the Samsung. I love a good hyperlapse or time warp or whatever you call it, a stabilized walking time lapse shot. Let's go ahead, set them both to 10x and see which one looks better.
A few things you should notice here. That 5K hyperlapse on the GoPro is looking a bit sharper than the 4K on the Samsung. I think its HDR and clarity looks better too. And of course the GoPro is a bit wider angle as well. But I think the biggest difference is seeing how much smoother that GoPro looks. It's doing an awesome job of removing a lot of the shakes and wobbles and just overall better processing.
Let's say you want to do some vlogging on one of these cameras. Which one is best? Well, for starters, we have that front-facing camera, the dual display setup on the GoPro, whereas in the Samsung, obviously we've only got one screen. Now sure, you could flip it around and use the selfie front-facing camera, but you're not gonna get the ultra-wide and all the benefits of the better quality rear camera setup. I really can't wait till someday maybe a Samsung placing a little display there or something on the rear of the camera. That would be super cool.
Now funny enough, in my research for this video, I found that there's a few phone makers that have tried this in the past. I wonder if we'll ever see this in a comeback, or possibly just majority of people don't even care. In slow motion, the S24 Ultra received a sweet upgrade this year with 4K 120, although I'll give the points over to the GoPro as it can do the same, but keep that wider angle, better stabilization, even its dynamic range is looking better, and it has much wider variety of resolution and frame rate options, like 240 FPS at 2.7K.
Now let's do a little pixel peeping. This is 8K video on the Samsung, so it's super high resolution. However, we're stuck at that 1X lens. On the GoPro, we can go up to 5.3K res, and this is 8:7 ratio, almost square, so you can switch it to horizontal, vertical. It's really sweet. Let's go ahead and point the camera at this little bench and do a little bit of zoom in digital crop on these high resolution recordings and see which one looks a little bit better. And a quick battery update, just got back in the car, was out shooting for about an hour and a half, and we're 34% on the GoPro, 77% on the Samsung. Massive difference, and youch, GoPro has never been great with battery life.
Now both of these sensors are actually really tiny, so in super low light situations, I'm sort of intrigued which ultra wide looks better. Comparing price tag is pretty interesting. The GoPro 12 is currently $350 on Amazon, or about 4 times the cost as the S24 Ultra, but you can make phone calls on it. I hope this video was helpful to someone out there, and if so, hit that thumbs up. I'll see you subscribers in my next video.